So the next side of things is going to be introducing and building the external side of things. So this is going to be the customer facing environment that we're going to be creating here. So to start with that, we'll go back to the interface and we'll actually need to create a brand new dictionary to support the external side of things, because right now we're in the internal side. The employees can only sign into this applications in this dictionary. Well, we don't want customers to sign into this dictionary. All right, so we create that new dictionary from system management and we'll put in our support dictionary name and we'll let this create. All right, so now that that is created, let's go ahead and switch over to our new dictionary. And the first thing I'm going to do here is we want to set up security. Now, we don't want to use the built-in security that we did for the internal dictionary because we already have a table that has the contacts, users, and password a part of that. So what we need to do is under the sign-on configuration is actually point to that table that we created beforehand, this support.mrcsec. Well, that's just the built-in, the default table. So here we're going to point to employee.contacts. The column user is going to be the contact email. That's going to be the sign-in user. And the password is contact pass. Now the other thing that's going to happen is normally when you would sign into the dictionary or you would sign in from the sign-on page, you're going to be taken to the menu. Well, I don't want to do that in this case. For the customers, I want to take them to a kind of a support portal landing page. So instead of the menu here, we're going to create, which we haven't done just yet, we're going to create a retrieval that's going to serve as a landing page with this. So I will take this and change both of these sign-on and sign-off redirects within here. And now we need to do is to actually enable security. So we'll come into our application menu and security section and simply enable security. And again, we're going to have to authenticate in order to enable security. So now that that is turned on, again, at this point, we don't have to do anything else with security because we're not going to be using the built-in menuing system. We're going to be using our own sign-in process and our own landing page. So before we actually create that landing page, we do have to register those three tables that I created way back at the beginning of the video to this dictionary. So we'll find our tables that we created. Okay, so now that the tables have been registered, now we can move forward and create that support landing page.